Welcome to the biggest week yet of This Week in the Future. OpenAI is overhauling their GPT models to make them multimodal. So when GPT-4 was announced, they promised multimodal capabilities like voice image recognition. They had examples of providing an image of all of the food in your pantry and then describing a recipe that you could create with that food. So when GPT-4 was announced, we expected that feature to come soon, and it didn't. People were wondering what was going on behind the scenes, and now there's been some transparency made, and these features are coming to us very soon. Here's what we know. We're going to be able to feed images and video and audio to ChatGPT. Multimodal LLM means that it can now take different input streams. It can take audio streams, stuff like you talking. It can take images and it can take videos as input. It can understand the contents of those, and it can also now output images, voice. Unclear if there's going to be a video feature yet. This is going to unlock a whole new world of possibilities for average users, and then for distinct types of users. It's going to be really game-changing actually for how people live their lives. One thing to note is, since images are now becoming a pretty critical part of this, probably going to want to download the GPT app on your phone. You're also probably going to want to get GPT Plus if you want to be able to access these features. But the example they show is taking a picture of your bike and performing a bike repair and asking questions and asking about specific parts of the bike with more images. I want to talk about a really specific group of users that this is going to impact a lot. OpenAI collaborated with a company called Be My Eyes, which is an org that builds tools for visually impaired users, blind, near blind users. And they built Be My AI, which is a tool to describe the visual world for people who are blind or have low vision. So Be My AI incorporates GPT-4V into their existing platform, which provides descriptions of photos taken by the blind user's smartphone. The goal is responsible deployment and identifying problems with GPT-4V and risks with GPT-4V and addressing them where possible. Through the demo, they learned that this model will often combine text blocks that are near each other. For example, it'll hallucinate. A user took an image of a menu, for example, and it just invented an item that doesn't exist, which is embarrassing if you're trying to order something and the server doesn't know what you're talking about, right? It should definitely not be used for high-risk tasks like identification of chemical compounds or foods. The list really goes on and on. If you're super interested, I recommend you check out the paper. This could basically break the use of CAPTCHAs for security purposes, but security risks aside, this is really incredible stuff. ChatGPT, GPT-4 can now see, hear, and speak. OpenAI has basically beat Google to a publicly available multimodal AI. Google's Gemini will be multimodal. It's a huge deal for OpenAI, and we're just touching the surface of the capabilities of these features. If you're curious about how something like ChatGPT works with multimodal, go check out this paper. Really short rundown is that it does, in 5 stages, multimodal input encoding, so encoding not just text, but every single one of these different data streams, aligns them in an LLM-centric way, prepares them for input to the LLM, and there's LLM-based semantic understanding of all the tokens from all the different sources, followed by an instruction following alignment where the model decides outputs it's going to use, which of the multimodal generative models it's going to use, because all these models are different. Then the last stage is actually using a model like Stable Diffusion to generate an output. Up next, Meta Connect just happened this past week, and I want to hit some of the main talking points here. AI is being integrated into Instagram, of course. That's AI image editing and generation based on new Emu model. They're going with the animal theme, for those of you familiar with Llama. They're launching Meta AI, an AI assistant, which is going to be integrated into Meta platforms like WhatsApp, Messenger, Instagram, etc. I want to take note, by the way, here. We're used to Meta now instead of Facebook, right? Meta with ownership of Facebook and Instagram, WhatsApp, etc. Now, I think we should take note that there's X as well. So Elon Musk is almost going for the same thing. So he changed Twitter to X, and now he's wrapping in all the companies that he owns and that are related to Twitter under the same X name. So there's certainly this concerted effort to try to bring in as many companies as possible under one hood. And I think that's critical because for development of these models and usage of these models, having an enormous scale of data, having multimodal type data, text stuff from Facebook and image stuff from Instagram Reels. It's really critical to be able to bring this all together to make the most powerful models. And then you can also develop a series of models and deploy them across all of your services rather than needing to build a separate one for each service, right? It's not Instagram Assistant, it's Meta Assistant. This is funny, this next piece of news. So they're introducing an ensemble of AI characters you can talk to for a specific use case. That's cooking, fashion, philosophy, et cetera. Some are based on real celebrities that Meta partnered with. Coming soon, you can talk to a photoreal version of Tom Brady. I'm curious to see what the usership over time for these kinds of models looks like because it's gimmicky. Meta's also launching AI Studio, where users can create their own AIs. There will be an API for developers, but also a sandbox for regular users to train their own AIs. AI Studio is going to be brought to the metaverse, where your AIs can be made into 3D characters. The writer strike in Hollywood has ended. There are a bunch of clauses regarding the use of AI that I want to make note of here. So we have that under this new agreement, AI cannot write or rewrite literary material. And AI-generated material will not be considered source material under the MBA, meaning that AI-generated material can't be used to undermine a writer's credit or separated rights. I believe the most important bullet is that under this new agreement, the Writers Guild of America reserves the right to assert that exploitation of writer's material to train AI is prohibited by MBA or other law. This means that there are significant protections now in place and lawsuits if things go south. A couple really quick pieces of news. Amazon invested $4 billion into Anthropic. So this is basically them giving a huge amount of money for computational hardware and for access to AWS services for training. This gives them a minority stake in Anthropic. For those of you who aren't familiar, Anthropic is one of the top tier generative model companies. It's like a sponsorship almost is the way I want to describe it, because this doesn't mean that Amazon is in charge of Anthropic, but it doesn't mean that Anthropic has committed to do their AWS spend through Amazon. They're going to learn from each other. Anthropic might be a little disappointed to be using what is one of the less popular AI training platforms, but this is really good for Amazon because it means they have like almost like a cheerleader for their brand. Google has DeepMind, and of course Microsoft has OpenAI. Amazon is now connected to Anthropic. So if Anthropic does really well, that means that they'll be spending a lot of money on Amazon services, which is good for Amazon, but it also means that people will see Anthropic doing well and recognize that their platform is built on AWS services. And when they want to build something themselves in the cloud, they'll look at Amazon and say, hey, this cool stuff was built here. That's everything for this week. If you enjoyed and want to stay tuned for more advancements in the space of AI, and if you don't want to fall behind your friends and your coworkers and your family, subscribe. Stay tuned for more.